to Mind Over Murder. The rules are simple. Each scoring area contains a variety of floating rings. The color of the ring denotes the type of object you need to throw it through in order to score a point. Vehicles go through blue, people through green, and the head of our very own Professor Genki through the pink ones. Score a point on every hoop within the time limit, and you win.
Good luck.
It's murder time, fun time. Welcome to Professor Genki's Mind Over Murder! Brought to you in part by everybody's favorite alien overlord, Zinyak.
That's right, folks. The Maven of Mascot Mayhem has teamed up with the Conqueror of countless galaxies to create an all-new Genki experience.
As folks at home know, by exploiting weaknesses in Zinyak's meticulously crafted simulation, our contestant has gained the power of telekinesis. But they will have to master the power of the mind to complete the challenges ahead of them today.
I can now see why the professor was so eager to join forces with Zinyak. This should make for an interesting addition to the Genki family of games.
Right you are, Bobby. So let's meet our contestant, the winner of Genki Bowl 7, and our favorite contestant, the President of the United States.
Or whatever bits are still floating around in space, right, Zach?
Too soon, Bobby. Too soon. Let's get to the action. So, Bobby, how do you think the addition of superpowers is going to affect the game?
A submachine gun is a fine weapon, but nothing, nothing compares to the unlocked potential of the human animal. Super speed, super jump, and moving things around with the power of your mind? I'm expecting high action and lots of flailing bodies.
Makes you wish you had superpowers, doesn't it, Bobby?
I'm just happy not to be stuck in a vat full of foul-smelling nutrient milk, reliving my worst fears for all of eternity.
You and me both, Bobby. You and me both.
Can you imagine Genki and Zinyak flying a...
And that's it for our first match!
Excellent job by our contestant.
Came in one fancy flavor. My strange behavior led to an outburst. The night felt right, Sid, here's the deal.
You need me to ravage you.
Maybe...
Don't worry. I'm fully equipped to pleasure you. I need help inserting a virus into the simulation, among other things. Do this, and I will reward you. Do not do this, and you will get nothing. Understand?
Yeah, I got it.
Enjoy upsetting Zinyak. Show him you are better than his people at his favorite game show.
Fans, to another round of telekinetic tomfoolery, where it truly is mind over murder.
Right you are, Zach, and here with us again today is that unstoppable force and the leader of the free world, the President of the United States.
And what a perfect contestant for the show, Bobby. So far, this is proving to be the perfect combination. An undefeated human with the abilities of an alien meeting the challenges of the mad professor and entertaining everyone in the galaxy. What more could our audience want?
Other than freedom from alien oppression, the reconstruction of their whole planet, and football on the television every Sunday, I can't think of a thing.
Now, Bobby, you know we're not supposed to speak ill of our most benevolent overlord, Zinyak.
I'm sure Zinyak had a good reason for blowing up the Earth like he did.
A good reason.
A very good reason, no doubt.
Let's check out how our contestant is doing, shall we?
So how do you think things are going for our contestant, Zach?
In this match, or in life in general?
I was thinking the first, but now that you mention it, let's talk about the second.
Well, I imagine it's not easy for them knowing that they're responsible for the deaths of billions of people through their hubris and what will ultimately be an unsuccessful bid to overtake Zinyak.
My thoughts exactly. Bringing about the near extinction of the human race is a heavy load to carry.
It sure is.
I feel dirty, Zach.
We're just the pawns of a megalomaniacal alien overlord, Bobby. It's not our fault. Let's get back to the action. This is some championship-level mind over murder, Bobby.
I agree. The president sure is giving the folks at home one heck of a show.
And I know Professor Genki is loving it.
Indeed. Everybody's favorite man-cat enjoys nothing more than murder, mutilation, and mascots.
He does love alliteration, Bobby.
I thought that was assonance.
Assonance is when the words begin with vowels.
Really? Well, you'll learn something new every day. I can't help but be impressed by this contestant, Zach. I feel fortunate to see this action firsthand. How about you?
I said,
how about you, Zach?
I can't do this! I can't do this anymore, Bobby!
Keep it together, Zach. You hate to upset our most benevolent overlord.
I miss my wife, Bobby.
So do I, Zach. So do I.
Anything else, Bobby?
Yeah.
I have determined where inserting my virus would be most effective. Protect the area while I do this.
Is on when it counts.
Thank you.
Good. Your reward is waiting. Come claim it.
Yeah!
You accomplished what I asked you to do, so here is your reward. Now, continue with this task if you value doing everything you can in this world.
Guess I don't have a choice.
Before I can upload my next program, I need another Zin Patrol dealt with.
You got the heart.
Still the best.
It came out in 2000, but it rocks as hard now as it did then. Here's Outcast with B.O.B.
Yeah, it's from National Underground. Off the mouse, can't stop the ground. Like a million elephants, a silverback, a random thing. Can't stop the train. Who wants us? Don't come unprepared. I'll be there, but when I leave there, better be a household name. Brother man telling us it ain't gonna rain. So now we sit in a drop top soaking wet. In a silk suit, trying not to sweat. Hit some of us without the net.
I have created a masking program, which needs to be uploaded with your help. Did you intend to do that? If I begin cheering, will it help? My faith seems to be well placed. The rift is beginning to stabilize. Maximum power to the rift has been achieved.
meeting new people.
Was Insane in the Brain off of Cypress Hill's triple platinum album, Black Sunday. From my stomping grounds in Detroit, here is the new wave icons, the Romantic.
Put the masking program in place. Disrupting the system through chaos will give it time to work.
This one. Was anybody using that?
Oh,
city needs some serious remodeling. Everybody should do this. Seriously. After that, I could use a massage. This is awesome. Seriously. Oh, this is always my favorite part.
Security breach. Lockdown in 90 seconds. Come on. Security breached. Lockdown in 60 seconds.
This was made especially to reward you. Now I need you to continue by stabilizing one of my rifts. Doing so will aid in earning you more bragging rights. And we'll get you a reward.
At least you're direct.
Thank you.
The rift tied to one of my viruses is your first task. Stabilize it.
They came from England. They stayed to rock our faces off. That was Blur, song 2. 4 MCs, 1 great track. Here's the Far Side with Oh Shit.
Have set up large firewall towers to keep me from disrupting their systems. They must be destroyed. I have created logic bombs which can be thrown at the firewalls using your telekinesis in order to bring them down. However, the Zin have their own bombs which you should watch out for. Be mindful that specific colors should be matched for maximum effect against the towers.
Thank you.
Created a masking program which needs to be uploaded with your help.
If you borrow,
what is wrong?
saints rule even here.
With the masking program in place, disrupting the system through chaos will give it time to work.
Sure, I could break the sound barrier. Don't run in the streets. Whatever.
You want to sing along? I'm not judging.
So expensive.
Welcome, Genki enthusiasts, to the third and final match of Mind Over Murder. So far, the Saints head honcho and former leader of the free world has been racking up wins in our latest event. How do you think it'll go today, Bobby?
Given this player's previous performances, I can only expect a great show and a big W in the win column, Zach.
I have to agree, Bobby. It seems there's nothing this contestant can't do, including outshining Zinyak's own people with her own powers.
Careful what you say there, Zach. Remember what happened to us both after your breakdown at the end of the last show.
Well, the Wardens have very big hands, Bobby.
Yes, they do. I'm just glad to be able to sit down comfortably again.
Oh, I hear ya.
Well, like my 8th grade gym teacher used to say, the probe is no joke.
Oh, you said that one. I hope our contestant is doing better than I am right now. Well, Bobby, seeing the president in action here reminds me of the tales about the king.
I was thinking the same thing, Zach. If only we had been around to see those matches firsthand.
Now, for those at home who haven't heard the stories, what do they need to know now?
This was decades ago. Zinyak had conquered a planet of warriors. Much like our contestant, one of them stood above the rest and challenged Zinyak himself. Zinyak threw everything he had at the man, but the king just did not stop. Eventually, Zinyak managed to rip the king's mind from his body and bury it deep within his own simulation. Ever since, the king has been looking to escape and get his revenge against our most benevolent overlord.
Well, let's hope we never see him again, huh, Bobby?
Oh, the king has probably driven himself insane by now. Can you imagine being locked away for so many years with just yourself to talk to?
I've had that dream, Bobby. It's cold and it's dark. And it's lonely, so lonely.
Oh, there, Zach. Come on now. You're never going to be alone.
Lonely.
Not while I'm around. Come here.
Lonely, so cold, I can't. Smashing performance by the contestant so far.
Smashing? I don't think I've heard you use that before.
Well, I'm trying something new, Bobby. What do you think?
You know, I've always wanted an occasion to use jolly good.
Oh, hello there, little British, are you? That's a classic right there.
Hard to pull off with an American accent, though. Like trying to use bloody.
And arse. What is up with Americans using arse?
Oh, yeah, arse never works. But I know people who use it all the time. I don't get it.
Well, some things are just mysteries, Bobby. I've been thinking, Bobby, have you seen the professor around much?
Not since the mass abduction and obliteration of the Earth, Zach.
I can't help but think he's watching over us from wherever he is, like a guardian angel.
A sick, sadistic, cat-headed guardian angel.
Or maybe he's hiding in the shadows with a baseball bat and a hand grenade just waiting for an opportunity to bash someone's head in and make them go boom!
Much more likely scenario, Zach.
I'm still the best.
Folks, tune into this event for.
Absolutely. That and your stellar commentary, Zach.
Well, thanks, guy. You know, you're no slouch yourself, Bobby. I have always been impressed by your wordplay.
Well, you forced me to step up my game in order to keep up with you, Zach.
We're running out of things to say, aren't we?
We absolutely are, Zach.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm probably gonna be late for my appointment.
Gas.
Professor Genki's Mind Over Murder!
Zack and I would like to thank Zinyak for his continued support of the show and for sparing our lives so we may continue to exalt his most highest glory. Good night, everybody!
In Steelport.
Soon you will be able to say you have done all my tasks for me. After you come talk to me again, that is.
Security breached. Lockdown in 90 seconds. Security breached. Lockdown in 60 seconds.
Like a big piece, bitch, before I cut your daughter. Your pedal talk about, then I hit the border. Pity pat rapper trying to get the vibe. I'm a microphone being trying to stay alive. When you come to A-Town, well, you may not lie, because it doesn't family gon' ride.
You have done well. Now I will no longer be the cause of you not completing all the tasks available for you to do. Here is your immediate reward as well.
Pleasure doing business, I think. Walk me through how Sid is gonna help us free Matt.
Are you really sure about this? I mean, I know he can help, but it's Matt Miller.
We need all the help we can get. How do we get him?
Well, I give Sid the proper cipher to connect to Matt's personal simulation, and he opens a gateway.
This should be a fucking adventure. Uh-huh.
I was shocked when the boss picked you to be the vice president, but you ended up working out.
That's only vaguely insulting.
Look, you sound just like Julius Little. Putting a guy who betrayed you in the number two slot seems like a great way to get killed.
I'm nothing like Julius.
Kinsey, we're ready.
I'm sending Sid the jailbreak.
Any last advice?
When you're inside Matt's virtual oubliette, there's a decent chance that I'll be focusing on interfacing with the intrusion countermeasures, so pay attention to the console commands.
Any last advice I'll understand?
Don't get killed.
Gotcha. Self-proclaimed hacker god ran all the cyber terrors into the syndicate back in Steelport. No, he's Asha's right-hand man in MI6. I just hope we can trust him like she does. You can give me a gun anytime, Kinsey.
Well, you don't have superpowers either.
Jesus Christ, Kinsey. Why the fuck are there words in my face?
It's a command prompt. Just give me a second.
This brings back memories.
Damn it! The camera's screwed up. We'll just have to deal with it.
Fucking 80s. Just throwing this out there, but I don't want to be staring at the ground for the rest of my life.
I'm trying, but I'm not used to the code they're using. Give me a second.
I'm up for more.
Is 3D?
Don't you dare hit enter, Kinsey!
Oops, sorry. Finger slipped.
Oh, thank God.
There should be three data towers controlling the security to Matt's prison.
Finally, I get to just blow shit up.
Well, I wouldn't want you to go outside your comfort zone.
I must say, I am amused at this attempt to save a man who tried to kill you once.
Three times, Zinyak. Try to keep up.
All the same, what is it you hope to accomplish? Mr. Miller is beyond your help.
We'll see about that.
Very well. Your futile attempts do entertain me, are cool.
Always feels good to kick ass. That's a lot of firepower.
Destroying the tower should destroy the tanks with it.
Miss Kensington is rather astute for a human.
Yeah, well, big towers controlling security on a linear path. Not very creative for your superior intelligence.
Ugh. Touché.
That's two. One more to go.
You know, you're still kind of on my virtual shit list, Kinsey.
Or what?
Last time we were in cyberspace, you turned me into a sex doll.
God, are you still mad about that? I said I was sorry.
You gave me access to the webcam you set up in Viola's room. That's not an apology, that's creepy. I'm up for more. Tower, then we grab Matt.
Oh, I don't think it should be that easy for you.
He's made the tower invulnerable. Hang on, I'll find a workaround.
I am impressed by Miss Kensington. Though this attempt is as futile as the life of most humans.
Oh, look, an alien with a superiority complex. Surprising.
Though this sentiment comes from more than just the Zin, my dear. Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to day. To the last syllable of recorded time. And all our yesterdays have lighted fools the way to dusty death. Our brief candle. Life's but a walking shadow. A poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage. And then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot. Full of sound and fury. Signifying.
Thanks for sharing your high school poetry.
It's a quote from Macbeth.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Coming up on Matt's prison.
How am I gonna start a prison break without a gun?
Chances are it's not a standard behind bars sort of prison. You'll just have to wing it.
Wing it. Great. What can go wrong?
Oh, and since I can't see what's going on in there, I doubt I'll be able to help you either.
Fuck me running.
Choice. Walk through the blue door and continue to face yet more failures at saving those closest to you. Your race will live on borrowed time and will, through your violent arrogance, wind up extinct. Walk through the red door, however, and I will release the humans whom I have collected. I will give them amnesty and even a ship from my fleet to do with as they see fit. However, in choosing this door, you will willingly submit yourself to execution. This is the moment where you can prove to be the savior of humanity, or its absolute destroyer.
What am I looking at?
This is your life as it led you to this point. All your past violence, crimes, and losses on display to remind you of one simple fact. Regardless of what I have done to your world, you were its greatest threat. The evidence is irrefutable. How many have died because you decided that driving on the sidewalk is faster than the road? Because you used a rocket in place of a bullet? Because you wouldn't submit to my rule? In the end, you only hurt those you are trying to protect. In the end, there is only one. True, the human race would be much safer without you in it. So, will you choose a path to extinction? Or will you sacrifice yourself as a savior? Ours is not to reason why. Ours is but to do or die. Make your choice.
What am I looking at?
This is your life as it led you to this point. All your
memories? It was total bullshit that you could only carry 200 pounds of bison meat. Wait, is that Matt?
Trapped in technology he doesn't understand, in a cyber world he can't control.
Matt, stay calm. I'll get you out.
Without Miss Kensington, very doubtful.
Empty space and a purple star.
This is but a glimpse of what I have conquered.
Why? What is it?
Terror, as personified by your literary culture.
A dead pirate with a black parrot?
It's a raven.
Why does the pirate have a raven? Is this the island that pirate came from?
Must you continue to display your plebeian intelligence?
Yes.
I tire of this. Deal with her on your own. Ta-ta.
I can deal with anything you throw at me, buddy. Jesus Christ, Zinniak, are you 13? Alright, pick up the phone and dial yourself out, Matt.
Don't like the idea of us sitting around. Shouldn't we be picking up Matt? The kid could be in trouble.
Keith, you gotta relax. The guy's an MI6 agent, for God's sake. He can take care of himself.
You needed help getting out, and you're the commander-in-chief.
That's a really good point. Why didn't we think of this earlier?
Oh, I did. I'm just not a big fan of Matt.
Kinsey!
Come on! Can't I get some payback? Got a little lost, big deal.
Or he got a little dead, who knows?
Oh, he's fine. He's probably having the time of his life exploring Zinniak's ship.
Every store you hack feeds me security data. I can use that data to insert a virus, which will open up a doorway back to the ship. So go hack while I work on the virus.
Got it.
Yeah.
let's try a friendly fire. Seems these are linked to a lot of weak areas in the simulation.